Hello mga katropang guro, and welcome to this educational video on hybrid learning and building remote learning relationship by nurturing teacher-student connection. What do we mean when we say hybrid learning? A hybrid learning is one where the delivery of instruction may be through a combination of face-to-face, classroom sessions or conventional session, and distance learning, particularly online class sessions. When we talk of hybrid learning, according to Doering 2006, hybrid learning model refers to the blending and mixing of the learning environments. So there are two environments that we are referring, the face-to-face classroom instruction and online environment. Hybrid learning and blended learning can often be mistaken. However, both are two distinct learning models. Blended learning combines face-to-face teaching with asynchronous learning methods, where students work on online exercises or learning experiences, interactive activities provided online by the teachers, and watch instructional videos during their own time and at their own pace. While hybrid learning is a teaching method where teachers instruct in-person and remote students, meaning to say at the same time, in-person and remote students at the same time. In hybrid learning models, asynchronous teaching methods can be used to supplement synchronous and face-to-face instruction. So remember, there are two things, no? Synchronous and asynchronous sessions will be conducted for hybrid learning model. So how do we implement hybrid learning approach or model? Simply, there are two learning modes that we should be using. First is the synchronous, and the second one is asynchronous. So when we say synchronous learning, it is more structured learning strategy where the courses are scheduled a specific time and in live virtual classroom setting. We can make use of Google Meet, Zoom, or Big Blue Button whenever we have synchronous for our class. In this way, students benefit from real-time interactions, hence get instant messaging and feedback when needed from the teachers who are teaching the lesson. The teacher will now discuss the lesson through online classes considering the platform, which is, for example, what are the platforms that we can make use for synchronous? We have Google Meet, we have Zoom, and also Big Blue Button. So while asynchronous, the students can do their work, you know, the interactive activities provided by the teachers at their own pace, at their own time. So the students in asynchronous learning cannot get instant feedback or message from the teachers. So additionally, the learning content is not provided in live classes or in conferences, but rather on different learning management systems. So what are some of the examples of learning management systems? We have Canvas, which of course we are using in FPU Roosevelt, then Moodle. We also have Edmodo, Schoology, and of course, Shobee, Google Classroom, and of course, Genial Learning Management System. So those are the learning management systems that we can use in order for us to provide learning activities for our students online. So they can do all the learning activities or interactive activities online at their own pace, at their own time. So that's asynchronous learning. The students can do the activities at their own pace and at their own time. So those are the ways in order for us to deliver our lessons. It could be through synchronous or asynchronous learning. But the most important in this time of pandemic is how do we connect with our students? So what are the things that we did so far in order for us to build relationship with our students? Particularly, we are nurturing teacher-student connection, especially in this time of pandemic. So allow me now to present to you my practical tips in order for us to build remote learning relationship and nurture teacher-student connection in virtual world. Practical tip number one, conduct survey of what students want and don't. So all you have to do is to ask your students, what are the things that they want in order for them to be engaged, to be interested with all the activities or learning experiences that we are providing them? And what are the things that are really difficult for them to understand? So in that way, we would be able to connect with our students. We would be able to know their weaknesses, to know their difficulties, and of course, their problems. Particularly in the use of the platforms that we have been using. So remember, it's very important to conduct a survey of what students want and don't. Next, practical tip number 2, make yourself available to them. Meaning, presence is very important. If there are concerns or problems being encountered by the students, as teachers, as educators, we should be there guiding them as guide and facilitators, especially in this time of pandemic. Remember that we really don't know the situation of our students. So therefore, we have to help them. We have to be there with them. Make sure that you are available. And next, of course, our practical tip number 3, finding out what is happening with them and then help them if needed. This practical tip number 3 is connected with our practical tip number 2. So therefore, it's needed to provide feedback to our students after identifying their weaknesses or their difficulties, particularly in the lessons. It could also be technical difficulties. So we have to provide them feedback. So there are 3 things that should be considered in providing feedback. Feedback, that means you tell them the purpose, you tell them the objectives. And then after providing the objective to your students, what you want them to know, what are expected of them, you proceed with feedback. Tell them their weaknesses. But of course, feedback alone cannot solve the problem or the weaknesses of our students. We have to provide solutions. So in providing feedback to our students, we have to provide as well possible solutions to their concerns, to their problems, or to their difficulties. And then after that, we can proceed with feed forward. That means we can proceed with our lesson after providing them with the necessary feedback that they need and the possible solutions to their problems. Practical tip number 4, which is of course second to the last, make the delivery of the content fun and engaging for active learning. So what do we mean when we say active learning? We are actually talking here about 3 things. So the 3 things that I'm referring to are of course student-to-student interaction, student-to-teacher interaction, and student-to-the-tool interaction. So those 3 things should be considered in order for you to consider that there is an active learning in facilitating learning. So how do we deliver engaging and fun virtual classroom presentation? There are also 3 things that should be considered. The student should be engaged, listening attentively, and of course, they would be able to master the most essential learning competencies. And I have, again, 2 tips for that. First, create interactions, which I already mentioned a while ago. But make sure to create interactions every 4 to 5 minutes so that at least your students would be engaged and that they would be able to master the most essential learning competencies. And then the second one, use synchronous software platforms that are simple and easy to use so that at least the students would not be having difficulty or problems technically. So you have to make sure to use the platforms that are easy to use, particularly to your students, so that at least technical problems will not be encountered. And that they will only focus on listening and then engaging and of course doing the learning experiences that you have provided them in order for them to master the most essential learning competencies. The last but not the least, of course, our practical tip number 5 in order for us educators and teachers to build remote learning relationships. Adjust the approach into shift expectations. You may include programs for student-teacher interaction as well. So what do I mean by that? All you have to do is to be very considerate. If there are problems or concerns and technical difficulties, you have to be very considerate to your students. Because in this time of pandemic, there are really problems that we cannot solve immediately. So therefore, we have to be there with our students. And then, as much as possible, we have to listen to them, ask them what is really their problem, and then try to help them. Another consideration for a shift expectation is this. If you provide deadline to your students, but because of intermittent connection, then you can give more time for them to submit so that at least you would be able to build relationship with them. Remember, this crisis, this pandemic causes a lot of concern, particularly in our educational setup. So as educators, as teachers, we really have to consider the situation of our students. Provide them more time in order for them to finish the performance tasks or the activities that you have provided. So my dear educators, choose to connect with your students. Connecting begins with us now. Thank you mga katropang guro. Till next time.